We've completed the basics of the Jensen estimate, sketched a floor plan, added the estimate line items, and selected the flood forms and claim reports we want to use for the assignment. Let's start filling in the flood forms administration. We click the Claim Reports drop-down, then choose Flood Forms Administration. Let's click Building Occupancy. This window allows you to enter certain information that is required in many of the flood forms. When we enter this information into the administration forms, we only enter it once instead of multiple times for multiple reports. This home is a townhouse that was built in the early 90s, so we'll enter this information in the top line. We'll enter the building dimensions and rooms, which we can easily determine in sketch and estimate items, then enter the number of baths. Let's click Calculate with Sketch to determine the square footage of the home, making sure to include all levels. We'll also use the sketch basement to indicate the perimeter. The rest of the building information fields don't apply to a condo unit, so we'll move on to the occupancy area. This has been the owner's principal home since 1997, so we'll enter that information in the top two lines. The owners occupy the basement and both stories, and the home is not a split level. Let's enter that here. The Jensen basement is not completely finished. The condition of the home and its contents are considered good, and it's not currently under construction, so let's enter that information in the building condition area. We'll also enter our property's firm date, which we found at msc.fema.gov, and click the post-firm checkbox since the home wasn't built until 1991. This completes the building occupancy page of the flood forms admin. Let's click Save to save our work.